Dorothy May was married just over a year. Then the devastating news. Her husband, Airman Isaac Anderson, died in a plane crash heading to Korea and the war.
After 50 years, she's never remarried.
Why do you think that is?
I'm hoping it was love.
And a burning desire to find out what happened, a desire taken up by his granddaughter, Tonja.
Here is Tonja's box of research. She started her mission 4 years ago, writing numerous letters to the President of the United States, former U.S. Senator Connie Mack, and Congressman Jim Davis. Each time the response, the U.S. Air Force has no plans for a recovery operation.
Then just 3 weeks ago, this videotape arrived from the Air Force. On it, a recent flyover of Mount Gannett in Alaska, where the plane crashed, likely from bad weather. Anderson and 51 others had taken off from MCORD Air Force Base in Tacoma, Washington. No one survived.
Why do you think that they went back after all this time and after 4 years of repeated attempts?
I still have that question, why?
Perhaps the renewed gratitude towards the military. The date on the tape shows the search was done September 10, 2002, a day before the 9/11 anniversary. The Air Force wanted to try one last time to bring the soldiers' bodies home. That was enough to prompt Anderson's family to finally say goodbye with a 21-gun salute, taps, and full military honors.
All she wanted was a flag. Her closure was a flag.